Monster RX 93.1 presents All Out, your daily morning pick-me-up. All Out hits, All Out celebrity interviews, All Out sports, and showbiz news. Your hosts, Rico Robles and Karla Aguas.
All right, ladies, you got once again, Ellen Adarna, Karla Aguas. Hi, girls.
All the way from Cebu. Ellen is hanging out with us all the way from Cebu. We're here. We're talking about her, her comeback, her being like, gee, I don't know, the funniest person so far. Like, seriously, I'm dying. She's hilarious. Ellen, okay, for all those that are tuned in, we were talking about your moment in Bali, the things that you went through there, and how you got past this very dark place in your life. Cut to, you come back, diba? What made you decide to share your story online? Because normally, I mean, for other people, they just be like, okay, I did this whole retreat, this whole wellness trip in Bali. I'm just gonna keep it to myself and then just come back parang like, hey guys, I'm back. But you took it a step further. You were like, no, I'm gonna explain
and you're sharing it, yeah,
and what I did. Diba? What made you decide to do that? To share your story?
Well, actually, because I feel like, you know, one of my brothers is going through the same thing and I can't open up to him. So I wanted him to see it. So that he's aware, for him to be aware of it.
You know, and when you shared that video,
I had the urge to like share it to people because I was really like so amazed that something like that worked and there's something like that, you know, something like that exists. And so I was just really amazed by it. So like I wanted to share it. I didn't expect I would get better. Mm-hmm. At first, I was like, whatever, I'm just, you know, when I did it or stuff like that. But then after I came back, I was like a different person. So,
did it start with like working out a lot? Did it start with that, the physical fitness first, waking up in the morning, going through the grind of it, and then from there, getting the confidence? Is that how it started?
Well, they just use the body as a tool to get to your mind. So, of course, they had to get me fit.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, like, they had to change my diet completely.
What's the diet now? What's the diet that you're doing?
I am a pescatarian as of the moment.
Mm-hmm. Love it.
And, but when I was there, it was just plain vegetarian.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And it was just really changing my old ways.
Mm-hmm.
And that was it.
But then, you know, the
which
jump roping part.
No, because when I was really at my lowest, I wasn't moving. I was not eating right. I was basically just sleeping and not doing anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And when I got there, like it had to change. I had to move a lot. I had to use my mind a lot. I had to eat right. I had to do exercises. Mm-hmm. And so that the whole thing changed.
And next thing you know,
had to clean my blood.
Clean the blood, hey, and you gotta make it for clarity, as they say, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and what she was saying was there are different programs. They adjusted to what you're there for because she was saying that people were going there for different reasons, not necessarily the same as what she went through. You come back, Ellen. You post that video. How was the reception? Like, were people receptive of it positively? Like, oh my gosh, Ellen, welcome back. Thank you for sharing. I mean, what was it like uploading that video and then like just waiting like, oh my gosh, what are people going to say about this?
I was surprised because I can only count using my fingers yung mga bashers. But yeah, it was really positive. So it's good because I think a lot of people can relate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, I think people thought that I would not go through something like that.
And you know, the cool part, Ellen, with you is that you were able to put off social media for a time, right?
Yeah, for 3 years.
Imagine, she did a social media cleanse for 3 years.
I had to because then I would go apeshit. I mean, I lost myself already. Wala na talaga, hindi na talaga ako makikita.
Yeah, but I mean, see, that helped you also in so many ways, and that's something that people can learn from as well. Put down the phone from time to time, diba? Like, when things get a little too much, go off social media muna. Oh.
Yes.
So now, we've got you on Facebook Live. People are excited. You're posting again on Instagram. Ellen, are you making a comeback when all of this is over?
No. Showbiz. No.
Yeah.
No.
No more.
Is that an exclusive, Monster exclusive right there? So you are confirming that after this lockdown, you're still not going to be returning to showbiz?
No.
So what will Ellen...
I mean, you know, I don't wanna say like no forever, right? Uh-huh. But definitely not in the next 7 years.
Wow.
Because, you know, being a mom, you have to be hands-on, right?
I have to be with my son in his, like, formative years.
Oh.
Which is the first 7 years.
Wow, galing.
So, like, oh, that's so wonderful.
I'm
that
a very hands-on mom, like, really. So, and yeah. So, there.
Just gave you guys an exclusive. Now, being a hands-on mom, what are the things that you look forward to on the everyday basis? Pag-ganun?
What do you mean, sorry?
Like, what are the things that you look forward to on an everyday basis, being a hands-on mom? Are you the one who wakes up first? Is it your baby that wakes up first?
Yes, I wake up before everyone wakes up. I mean, now that, you know, I came back from Bali, everything changed. Mm-hmm. But when I was depressed, I would like wake up at 10 and then just sleep. But I was still hands-on, like I would sleep with him. I was just at home with him. But that time I was just really empty inside as well, because postpartum, that is natural, right? But now, I wake up at 4:30 or 5.
Wow.
That's early. Wow.
And then I meditate for 30 minutes. And then I go back to him. And then I wait until he wakes up. This is my quarantine life. Huh? This is the quarantine life.
Yeah, this I gotta hear. Because everyone has a quarantine schedule now.
Yeah. And then I go back to him and then wait for him to wake up. And then breakfast. And then he plays outside or swims. And then while he's swimming or playing outside, I work out. That's my me time.
Mm-hmm.
And then at around 11, I put him to sleep. So he sleeps at 11 to 2, more or less. And that's where I have my me time again. And in the afternoon, we play. And then dinner. And when he's playing, another me time. And then dinner. And then I put him to sleep at around 7 or 8.
And then me time some more.
And then me time some more.
That's when the music comes in and the guitar playing, right?
That's
so important, that you're allotting me time. I think a lot of people...
It is essential for a happy individual.
Aww. Nice. Well, on Facebook Live, by the way, Laura Lee says, happy to see Ellen back on her feet. happy and strong. Way to go, Ellen. Yay, woohoo.
Thank you.
There's so much love, I swear, Ellen. Like, people have missed you, and this new you, like, it's such a bright light, I swear. Okay, when we return, Monsters, remember, we're also on air. We're going to be talking to her about some fun things that she's been doing, what she's looking forward to once lockdown is over. Because as of right now, we're all stuck at home.
We're all running on the same sched, right?
Yeah, we're all like following a certain schedule. So what are some of the first things that she's going to do when she can finally leave the house? Where is she going to go? What is she going to do? We'll talk about that and more. Don't forget, if you have questions, at RX931 over on Twitter or on Facebook Live, just head on over to Facebook.com/RX931 and comment down your question.
Just okay. A deep sleep lang, yeah.
Hi, girls.
Ever since.
I'm not mentally drained. Yeah, ever since.
Grabe. Like, I love that you're such a hands-on mom. That's awesome.
Yeah.
That sounds hard,
expect,
though.
Didn't expect. I mean, I didn't expect, how do I say it? Don't. Or are not expecting.
I think people
I'm
are
sure
just.
They think that I'm just like in the club drinking. This party girl is still the same.
Well, now you can share with the world that you are transformed, girl, because
we're learning a lot. We're learning so much. We're learning so much.
And I love it. My gosh, thank you for sharing with us about your showbiz decision. I think that's so, so wonderful that you're going to focus on being the hands-on mom that you are for his formative years. That's fantastic. Like, oh my gosh. He's going to be one happy, happy, happy kid.
Yeah.
How old is your baby?
He's turning 2 this June.
Oh, okay.
That's awesome. Okay, Monsters, you can comment your questions, okay? Yes, we're on FB Live. We can ask her some questions now. Rico, do you want to do the fun random questions that you prepared?
Yeah, we could do some random questions. You want to put that? We'll put that on air as well. Or you want to do it here live?
We can do any because we're still on live, so people can see. Yeah. They can hear us. What
Hello,
we're going to talk about.
Okay.
Want to do your random questions?
Yeah, sure, sure. You know, Ellen, for those that are watching us, this is, of course, on Monster RX93.1. We're on Facebook Live. So, hi, guys. She's coming from Cebu. Carla's from San Juan. And I'm here in Ortigas explaining you guys some stuff. So, we prepared some random questions for you, Ellen. Is that okay for you?
Yes.
All right. So, one of the things is that, let's see, what's your favorite color?
Yellow.
Yeah. Why yellow?
Always been.
Why yellow?
I don't know. Because it's bright. I don't know.
You know, I just have to comment this right now. I don't know if you guys feel the same way, but it's not even because the sun is behind you right now. But parang you are so bright and light now. Like, you're so happy.
Know.
Like, you're
I am.
Yeah, glowing,
it's
sobra.
Really showing. It's really showing. It's amazing. Okay, next random question. I mean, we're technically on lockdown, so everyone's at home. People are binge watching things right now. They're following different shows. What are you doing when you actually have the time? Because I know you're a mom. What are you watching during this whole thing?
I'm not.
Really?
I'm not watching anything. Like, I'm just not in the mood yet to watch something. Shows.
But what's your favorite movie? Like, something that ever since you can watch it over and over and over again?
Before Sunrise.
Before Sunrise. It's not that it's old. It's a classic. We're going to go with the fact that it's a classic, okay?
Are you into...
Well, that one, I can watch that over and over again. And I cry. And I still cry.
Every single time.
Every single time.
How about favorite cartoon?
Cartoon. Little Lulu.
Oh my God.
Major
throwback. Do you remember the song? Little Lulu. With freckles on a tip. Oh my God, girl. This is too much. Okay. Now, for those that don't know, Ellen's actually doing a no meat for the next couple of days. We're talking 100 days. She's pescatarian. But Ellen, what is your go-to favorite food? Like happy, sad, celebrate, no matter what. Like this is the food, the dish that you will turn to and just be like, yes, I'm going to have this.
Shawarma with lots of garlic sauce.
How many can you eat? How many? How many can you eat? Huh? How many can you eat in one sitting?
One lung. Kahit one bite, okay na. Now, one bite would be like...
That is
kasi
love.
Kasi vegetarian eh. Kaya ang hirap.
Do you cook?
Yeah, I cook.
What's your favorite?
Just, you know, simple, basic meals. Not like chef kind of.
But what's the best thing you can cook? Like your signature dish, no matter how simple?
Paksiw. Lechon paksiw, Cebuano style.
Whoa!
Which is like just salt and vinegar and spices. That's it. Wow. Because the paksiw that you have in Manila, you put mang tomas, no?
Yeah, we put the liver sauce. That's right. Yeah. In Cebu, they like... Iba yung lechon nyo, no? In Cebu. It has a lot of flavor in it.
Yeah, so we just put vinegar and salt and spices. That's it. But mine's really good.
So, Karla, remember, simple lang daw yung niluluto niya, no? Simple lang daw, no?
Simple lang, pero it's like this dish that no one
else can. Lahat ng ex-boyfriends ko na in love doon.
Hey! Namely!
Namely, wag na! Alam niyo na!
We're on a different side na, di ba? We agreed. Facebook Live.
Ah, kita mo, pag tinanong, may asim pa. May asim talaga.
May asim ka pa ba? Diba? Yes, through my paksiyo.
I love it. Oh, Samantha over on Facebook Live is watching from Bali.
No, she's my friend who did the program before me.
Oh, cool. I love it. Ooh, I like this. This question is from Arlene over on Facebook Live. Hi, gorgeous mom. What's your most favorite thing to do or what do you look forward to during your me time? So the little me times that you give yourself throughout the day. What do you love to do?
My me times, like, because now, wala, because quarantine, but massages, like, 3 times a week.
What type of massage? Is it like, a Muay Thai kind of Thai massage.
Happy ending. I'm kidding. Just like I don't mean like when they yung ano the knots.
Oh my god! Yeah, like when they take out all the lamig.
That kind of massage. I don't know what you call that. Deep tissue massage.
Technical terms. Massage.
Me time. My me time is massages, and then I read. But cooking. I prep my meals.
Grabe, and it's so wholesome and like yung parang tipong like look at you. I like to read and cook my food. No, but that's so awesome. I love that.
Oh, no, from but I've always been cooking my food, and you know, it's always been ang yung nadagdag lang ngayon is the meditations, which I never did before.
But you said it's really helped you so much, diba?
Yeah.
Oh, a lot of people are now turning into home chefs, apparently, because of this quarantine. People are showing off the things that they're learning to cook. You know, they make all these pies and all of these different dishes. What's one thing
Guilty
that you
dyan.
Want to learn how to cook during this entire quarantine? Like, if you were to pick a recipe na, I'm going to try to master this.
I want to learn how to bake, though. I don't know how to bake.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, baking is very, like, very difficult.
I've never baked like bread or pastries in my life.
So, kahit yung mga box mix, yung mga super simple, just add water mix.
Start with the pancake.
I can't remember. A pancake, I cook it with a pan. In a pan.
Yeah.
But that's it. But nothing like, you know, baking and like measuring all that stuff, none.
True.
So we gotta move forward. We gotta move up to brownies, tapos toaster, that small one, and you work your way up.
But that's not considered baking, right? If you use the toaster,
it's baby steps.
Don't listen to Rico. Baby he made steps. Pasta by flattening out the dough. Oh my god, girl.
Yeah, I don't even know how to make a dough.
Oh, Rico.
Oh, ganito yan eh. How to make a dough. You get your flour, then you make halo-halo with an egg and water. Water. Tapos,
wala akong talent dyan.
Speaking of talent, Ellen, hidden talent that you can share with us. Especially now, nasa video tayo.
I think I showed you guys my piano skills and my singing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's on IG. If you haven't seen it yet, she was playing the piano. But if for those who didn't see it, would you like to recreate? Is there a piano beside you now?
No, it's downstairs.
Don't put her on the spot.
She's like, it's downstairs.
No! Not yet.
How many songs can you play on the piano?
How many what?
Songs can you play?
A lot.
What's your favorite song to play?
I just have to practice it though. Like, I just have to polish it. Like, give me 2 days to practice the song and then I'm good. But the one that it's my go-to because I learned this and it's like, it's always been... my warm-up has always been 1,000 miles. Like, I can play it with closing my eyes.
Wow.
And not thinking and not focusing. Like, it's automatic.
First of all, classic. 1,000 miles.
Oh, diba?
That's like the most classic piano song. I love that.
And that's not easy. That's a very, very tough song. I mean, that's Vanessa Carlton. I mean, that's... Iba. As in... Were you classically trained?
Yeah, since I was 7.
See? How many monsters that are watching now, listening? How many of you knew that? She classically trained in piano. Mm-hmm. I know. Shanna. Ayoko na. Can I just leave the call? You know how I'm stuck na nga in the house, I feel this small.
But what other things do people don't know about you na marunong ka? That sort of get it, people by surprise other than playing the piano.
What? I don't know. I think I've shown everything. I share a lot of things. You know?
It's always been an open book.
Yeah.
Do you plan to
write it? Now.
Wow. Oh,
I'm not as
curious. So mysterious. I love it. Wait, you're saying no to showbiz for now because you want to spend time with your son. But will we be seeing more of you online? Like, will you be sharing more things on your Instagram? Do you have plans of starting maybe like a YouTube channel series?
No, YouTube, not even. Just Instagram. You know, I can't even edit videos. I don't know how to... I just got Zoom, for God's sake. And, because I spoke to... At first, I was interested in doing YouTube, but I spoke to some friends. Mm-hmm. You know what? It's like showbiz. I mean, you really have to make time for it. And I'm not ready for that kind of pressure. You know, I want to focus on my son.
You know, Carla's a really good YouTuber. She does have a lot of content as well. And how many hours does it take? It takes a lot of hours, no, Carla, to edit.
We're here to talk about Ellen. No, yeah, not talking about
a lot of
my
hours.
Videos. No.
It takes a lot of commitment.
Yeah. And not only that, like, I have, like, how long do you work on it? Like, for, I mean,
I think it's the editing, like, that's the hardest.
Do you work on it every day or?
Like, filming is not as difficult as it seems, especially like if you were to start one because you're used to being in front of the camera. So filming is not difficult. It's the editing talaga that takes a while. Like even if you ask actual YouTubers, it's always the editing because the stuff that you have to take out, if you're going to put effects, to make sure that the video is, you know, consistent. That's what makes it difficult. Eh. But I feel like in the future, like if you do decide, you would be so funny on YouTube. I feel it.
Like a lot of people tell me, like, you should get YouTube, you should make a YouTube account or something. I was like, you know what? It would have been perfect when I was like in my 20s. Uh-huh. Oh my God, like that would be a shit show.
See, moments like this would be hilarious.
Iman. But it's just like my life is not as interesting as it was. I'm just home and I just go to the office and that's it. Like I barely even see my friends, so it's not really that interesting. You know? I'm not saying that, you know, pero for now, ganun pa siya.
So, eh kung may editors na mag-present sa'yo na, oh, Ellen, footage lang, padala mo lang, kamila bahala. Game ka ba?
Footage? What do you mean?
Like, you just have to show you.
And then they'll edit it for you.
Ha, it's so hard. Yung me time ko nga parang yung me time ko parang 1 hour, 2 hours, ganun
lang. Mababawasan ba?
Tapos ano pa yun? It's cut, like it's not straight, you know. So mahirap pa for now. But baka after when malaki-laki na si Elias, the next 7 years.
Okay, see? So don't force her, Rico. I know you're Rico Chismoso and you want all of that soup, but don't force her, okay? She's happy where she is right now. You just celebrated your birthday. We saw it on
happy
IG.
Happy birthday.
Tributes to you. Happy, happy birthday again. Everyone was sending you jump rope.
I know!
How was that? Like, when you started receiving it, like, were you just laughing? Were you killing?
Yeah, I was like, what is this? What are people doing? Like, why are they tagging me? And then, like, I was like, oh, I'm inspiring them. It's good. I'm doing something good.
And you do the signature move, you know, where you ano yun, para ka umuupo tapos gaganunin mo. Yeah, you do a double under squat and people are trying to do it. And how does it
some
feel?
Some are really getting it though. Some are getting there. Some are learning fast.
Hey, for those who can't get it, ano yung tip na mabibigay mo sa kanila? As in, galing eh.
My tip is before you do a double under squat, you have to do a single first and you have to do a double. Straight, like try doing the singles for like 5 minutes straight and you know get your cardio up, and then if you can do 5 minutes like singles, then maybe you can proceed to doing doubles and then you start doing practicing the squat. So you really have to what do you call this, parang to up your cardio, something like that.
All while trying to look as cute as she does when she jump ropes, right?
Yeah.
But let's be honest. What are our faces like when we jump rope? I'll give you a sample.
I'm perfect pa nung ano, alam mo yung perfect kasi everybody's doing home workouts kasi quarantine. So sobrang timing na pinost mo yun. And next thing you know, wow, grabe. Ibang klase.
Everyone.
No, kasi wala nin, napilitan lang ako mag-post din and to do it. Actually, wala akong plano mag-jump rope. I was just gonna run sa treadmill. But then I was in quarantine in Mövenpick with my best friend. Like, I wasn't allowed to go out of the unit. Like, the management made it clear.
Oh, wow.
I can't go out of the unit. So I was like, oh, I can't jog. I can't go outside for a walk. So I was like, I have to jump rope. So, yun lang yun. But wala talaga akong plano mag-jump rope again, like, because it's really tiring.
And for all you who don't know, you know, Ellen's been jump roping for a long time and she could do it for a long time. I'm talking like 30, 60.
Since I was a kid!
I mean, that's how I met her at the gym, Karla, jump roping. I was like, who's this girl jump roping for like 45 minutes straight? I was like, holy!
Siya na, no? Tapos, ang
grabe,
ganda pa niya, even
grabe.
If she's sweaty. Yung tipong, commercial ba to, girl? Why? Why do you look like that? Then I look like a tomato pag ginagawa ko. Oh, you're saying, di ba, na you weren't even allowed out nung time na yon, and now, more than ever, we're not really allowed to go out, we're not really allowed to do anything until all of this is over. What are some of the things that you are looking forward to doing once this is over? Like, are you gonna go out with your friends? Are you going to go to a restaurant? Mag-buffet ka pa? What exactly are you gonna be doing? Like, your top of your list when all of this is over.
Top of my list. Actually, nothing. Because I told you, I'm doing this post program. I have 100 days. So I can't drink. I can't eat pork or beef. So, I'm just, wala. You know?
It's one step at a time. After 100 days, one step at a time, as they say.
But, you know, I'm looking forward to getting a pedicure, getting my hair done, and getting a massage.
Oh, preach it, girl.
COVID-free masahista, please.
I swear, she really has no filter. I love it. Like, she's so obvious. That's so cute. When your 100 days are over, what's the first meal that you plan to have? Because right now, you're pescatarian.
Shawarma.
Oh, Ellen.
People are gonna send you,
the stick with the shawarma meat. Parang like, here, congratulations on 100 days.
All right, we're gonna go back on air now, Ellen, and then just invite everybody to check out or some final shout outs and thank yous, and then
message to fans.
All right.
How do you check out? Check me out.
I'll come back.
Like, just say thank you. Voila, it's just really a thank you. That's really all I can say. Oh, yun din yung wish ko for you guys. Aww. To be happy and well.
Oh, diba?
Positivity. Oh, na.
Oh, nakita niyo. Oh. Ellen, advice mo sa mga hindi happy ngayon.
Wow!
You know, life is a vicious cycle and it's normal to have ups and downs. And, advice? Advice talaga? Quote! My favorite quote.
Okay.
Everything is going to be okay. If it's not okay, it's not the end. Char.
Ang ganda na eh, pero nag-char kasi.
Grabe.
Oh, that's a good quote though.
Well, thank you, Ellen. Thank you for spending time with us here on the show, and thank you for taking time. I know you're very busy, you're very hands-on mom. Congratulations on a beautiful, beautiful baby, and also happy, happy birthday once again.
We wish you well. Like, we wish you nothing but the best. You deserve it. I mean, based off of this interview palang, this hangout, you're really so, so sweet. And I really hope that you continue on this journey of light and bright and just pure happiness. Guys, unfortunately, for the next few years, you aren't going to be seeing her on Showbiz, but she posts a lot of updates on her Instagram, right? You're posting more on Instagram now?
Oh, but like there's endorsements, yes, and stuff like that, but no taping na.
Okay.
So unang billboard that we're gonna see with Ellen is a big shawarma and a billboard, and you know it's gonna be.
Shout out if anyone is watching the Facebook Live and you know somebody who has a shawarma company, you know who your endorser is, man. She loves it, so she doesn't even have to lie. She's gonna be like, hi.
Well, thank you, Ellen. Thank you for taking time. And for those who are watching, thank you guys very much for taking time on a fantastic Friday. Once again, for those listening via RX931, we have Ellen Adarna joining us. So invite them again to your socials. Go ahead, Ellen.
You on Instagram.
I invite them to what?
To your socials.
Guys, follow me talaga. Like, if you like, go. If not, walang pilitan. Nakahiya.
Yeah, but we're very excited sa feed mo as is. It's must-see IGTV, man. So it's really, really fun.
Okay, my Instagram account is maria.elena.adarna. And that's it. I'm not active. I don't have Twitter now. And that's it. It's just Instagram. And yeah.
All right. So there you go. Ellen, thank you.
Oh, there you guys go. Okay. If you want Twitter. Ellen updates, you can get them on her Instagram. Those are the never before seen, behind the scenes, real life, real time updates of the Ellen Adarna. Oh, diba?
Pinaka-totoong reality show on IG, right? There you go, ladies and gentlemen, another awesome, fantastic Friday. Ellen Adarna live.
All Out with Rico and Karla. All Out music and all out fun. Monday to Friday, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. only on Manila's hottest Monster RX93.1.